My name is Avner Vengosh. I'm a geochemist. I work on water, and I study water contamination in different parts of the world. We work on different areas and trying to understand what is the source of water contamination, why water are being contaminated, and how it affects human health. We currently work on India, in China, previously we worked in Morocco, Jordan, in the United States, and in North Carolina. We use a wide range of geochemical and isotopic tools that we have developed here at Duke. We can tell whether these contaminants are naturally occurring, whether they're coming from coal ash, whether they're coming from oil and gas operation. So we build these very sensitive methods, and I think that's make us a bit different from the rest of the world. We've been studying coal ash since the Tennessee Valley Authority, the TVA coal ash spill, that took place in Kingston in 2009. We looked and we conducted several field work and several leaching experiments in the lab, and we characterized the chemistry and the isotope ratios of coal ash, basically building kind of a fingerprint. What in coal ash and how you identify it once you have contamination. And what's in coal ash? Everything. We have arsenic, radioactivity, selenium, boron, a long list of elements that are extremely toxic, and some of them are carcinogenic. We investigated 15 sites all over the southeast of the US, and we found that all of them are leaking, and shallow groundwater and surface water adjacent to those sites are already contaminated. We are investigating what is the impact of fossil fuel extraction on water resources. Ironically, we found that those fracking chemicals that people are so afraid from hydraulic fracturing, most of them will be retained and remain with the shale. And the water coming out is actually saline water. But it does contain other level of contaminants. Once the chemistry of the wastewater mixed with the river, once you take this blend and treat it, which you do in any drinking water utilities, you would generate another type of chemical called disinfection byproduct, which is extremely toxic, which go directly into your drinking water source. And we found that even a tiny amount of wastewater, less than 1%, being added into the water could induce the formation of those disinfection byproducts in a treated water. That is a potential health risk to those living all over in the watershed of oil and gas operations.